video, we'll discuss what you need to know in order to ride your bike safely and to comply with the rules of the road. The three keys to riding safely on your bike include using safe equipment, having good riding skills and techniques, and defensive riding. One of the most important things that we can do to ensure a safe ride is to make sure that our bikes are in good working order. This means that before every ride, you're going to check the key parts of your bike to make sure that nothing is loose or damaged. This includes your wheels and spokes, your handlebars, and your seat post. To get a better idea on how to do this, let's watch this short video on how to check your bike before a ride.
In this video, you'll learn how to inspect your bike before going out on a ride. Make sure you have the appropriate safety gear, such as helmets and lights, as well as the tools and materials you might need for roadside repairs. For more on this, see our series, Roadside Bike Maintenance and Emergency Repair. The most important thing to check are the brakes. Lift the wheel and spin it. The wheel should spin freely with no wobble. And then stop spinning as soon as you squeeze the brakes. Test both wheels. You can also squeeze both brakes and try to push the bike forward to check if the brakes are functioning properly. Brake pads should not be worn, and both should contact the rim squarely at the same time. The tires should be inflated to the correct pressure, normally indicated on the sidewall itself. Note that most small hand pumps will struggle to attain this pressure for a lot of road bikes. The tires should have a good, unworn tread. There should be no cuts or tears. Pluck the spokes lightly to make sure they're tight. Loose spokes will cause the wheel to spin unevenly. The quick-release skewer or wheel bolts should be tightly secured. The frame should have no cracks in it. Check the joints of the frame as well. Headset bolts should be tightened so that the handlebars don't slip. There should be no creaking or rocking of the headset bearing when the handlebars are turned from side to side. The seat post should be tight and shouldn't slip. Run through your gears to check that the front and rear derailleurs are working properly. The crank should be on tight and should spin smoothly. Check the pedals as well. The chain should be well greased, but not too caked in grime. Make sure there is no grease on the rims, as this will prevent the brakes from functioning properly. A quick bike check can avoid emergency roadside repairs and ensure your safety. Enjoy your ride.
So let's talk about the other types of equipment that contribute to our safety on the bike. Probably the most important piece of safety equipment is your helmet. On the team and training cycle team, you can't ride without one. Helmets these days come in all kinds of shapes, colors, and sizes, but the most important thing is to make sure that it fits properly. A helmet that is too big for you or is not fastened properly under your chin is not going to do you any good. You'll know that your helmet fits properly and is adjusted properly when it's level and low on your forehead, where the strap, once it's buckled, is tight underneath your chin, and the sliders on each side of the helmet are right underneath your earlobe. Another important part of our cycling equipment is cycling gloves. A good pair of gloves can help secure your grip on the handlebars, and many of them come with pads in the palm, which will help with comfort on a long ride. We also want to be sure to protect our eyes from the elements. The best way to do this is to be sure and wear a good pair of sunglasses that protect you from the sun, the wind, and debris. While they may not be your ideal fashion choice, wearing brightly colored clothes on the bike will really help you to be seen by drivers, other bicyclists, and pedestrians. When riding at nighttime or in overcast conditions, it's essential to have a bike light that will illuminate both you and your bike. Bike lights come in all colors, shapes, and sizes, so pick one that fits your style and the kind of cycling that you plan to do. The second key to safe riding is to master the basic riding skills and techniques that will keep you safe on the bike. The first skill that we have to master is to ride your bike in a straight line. And while this sounds easy, it's actually harder than it seems. Many road bikes are performance machines, and with their skinny tires, it can be difficult to ride your bike in a straight line. But don't be discouraged. With a little practice, you should be able to acquire this skill. And once you've mastered riding in a straight line, a little more advanced skill is to glance over your shoulder while continuing in a straight line. This skill is helpful to check for danger behind you and also when rotating in a pace line. The secret to a good head turn is to actually drop your opposite elbow by a few inches as you're turning. The long hours that we spend in the saddle requires that you learn how to eat and drink while moving. Since this skill requires that you take one hand off of the handlebars, you might start by simply touching your water bottle while it's in its cage and returning your hand to the handlebars. Again, with a little practice, this skill will become second nature. Brakes, of course, are a critical safety component of every road bike. And while the physics of braking and the forces that are exerted on your body and your bike can be complicated, learning how to brake is not that difficult. The brake lever on the left side of the handlebars controls the brake on your front wheel, and the brake lever on the right hand controls the rear wheel. You may remember as a child being taught to not use only your front brake in order to stop yourself. And it's true, this can have dire consequences on a road bike as well. The secret to good braking technique on a road bike is to have steady pressure applied to both braking levers, with about 60% of the pressure applied to the rear brake and 40% to the front. The next important skill to learn is avoiding obstacles. Some obstacles in the road can be very small, and others not so small. The best choice is always to try to avoid the obstacle while moving your bike smoothly out of its way. When avoidance isn't possible, however, try to absorb the shock by taking some weight off of your seat and standing on your pedals. Another obstacle that we often face are railroad tracks. To avoid getting your tires stuck in the grooves, always cross railroad tracks at a 90-degree angle. Street curbs can also present problems for road bike tires. The seam where the asphalt meets the concrete apron is often a place where tires can get stuck in cracks. Try never to ride on this concrete apron and stay a safe distance away from all curbs. The final riding skill that you'll learn is the use of hand signals. While making a turn, simply point in the direction that you plan to go. You can hold your palm backwards to signal that you are stopping, or sometimes we use a closed fist. There are many other hand signals that you'll learn along the way, and generally they're used to point out obstacles to the people behind you. The last safety key is to learn how to ride defensively. While it may not be that common with cyclists in general, our team and training cycle team will obey all traffic laws at all times. Keeping your eyes on the road ahead of you will help you to plan for any unanticipated events. And when riding in a pace line, don't focus on the rear tire of the rider immediately in front of you, but rather keep your eyes up and look at the road past him. Once you've mastered the skill of eating and drinking on your bike while moving, be sure and do it only in safe spots. It can be really helpful to try and make eye contact with motorists as you approach intersections or make lane changes in order to provide a silent communication between the two of you. One of our goals at Team in Training is to be the most courteous and friendly cycling group on the road. And speaking of cars, you should assume that they do not see you as you plan the direction that you want to ride. And remember to use those hand signals to communicate with drivers and bikes around you. Cyclists are required to ride as close to the right-hand side of the road as is safe. When you ride along a line of parked cars, however, be careful to not ride in the door zone where you might be hit by an opening door. This usually means staying 3 to 4 feet to the left of any car. And when you see a gap between parked cars, just continue riding straight ahead and don't swerve between them, because this will make you seem unpredictable and even invisible to the rest of the traffic. On the Team in Training cycle team, we will generally ride in a single file as close to the right-hand side of the road as is safe. We will not generally ride two or three abreast in a way that blocks the road. The exception to this rule is when you're overtaking and passing another cyclist, or in certain circumstances like construction, when you're required to take the lane in order to be safe. It's dangerous and against the law in California to talk on a cell phone while on your bike. If you do need to use your cell phone while riding, just pull over to the side of the road and stop. It's also unsafe and against the law in California to wear headphones that cover both ears while on the bike. Most importantly, riding defensively means no surprises. Our goal should be to always ride smoothly and not to accelerate, to brake, or to turn in ways that will surprise those around us. Cycling with the Team in Training cycle team is an amazing experience that will teach you new skills, provide lots of thrills, allow you to make lifelong friends with other cyclists who are also cancer-fighting heroes, and help to make you safer on the road.
Well, it's safe to dance. Yes, it's safe to dance. Well, it's safe to dance. Well, it's safe to dance. Yes, it's safe to dance.